Dude, it's so crazy. Like, I think in any of these top 16 now, I can't predict anything. You know, like, I just don't know what's going to happen. But yeah, Double, I think, you know, he's the best law player in the world because he's placing the highest. I think that's just how it goes. So, you know, he's the law player to watch. That's what I've been doing. I'm learning, taking notes. And this is an interesting matchup, right? I mean, obviously, you guys know that Double's going to use Law. And Knee picks Steve Fox into it. You know, and everyone's out there at home saying, but Law has a punch parry. I don't understand, man.
Yo, back one. To answer that question, Wall, you might be dead.
Might be.
Just to let you know.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Floats him out.
Yes,
Double.
Sir.
Gonna get the wall. Dang. That's pretty fast slide.
That was a good slide. Solid. I love the fish there for the forward.
One of them getting to that range. Checking him with those jabs and just dashing up, fights his way back to the middle of the stage right now, but still.
That's risky too, man. He's swinging a lot. Steve, of course, counter character. And that thing about Knee Steve, he doesn't always just swing for the counter. He doesn't always look for down forward two or get back one, right? He lets you get comfortable swinging and then he hits you with the counter.
I mean, I think that's one of the main things that Steve has going for him in a lot of matchups. My gosh. And then he taps him one more time himself. He said, you're going to tap me, I'm going to tap you back.
Oh my God, that was a round stolen if I ever seen one. Ooh, okay.
Oh, now you knew what that looks like, huh? You know what that looks like from the outside as a Law player, huh?
Nah, that was beautiful. I've always known what that looks like. Why did they use Law?
Yeah, I got a kick too.
He used a punch parry. He says a puncher.
Look at my boy Knee just pushing to the wall. Double's like, yo, you need to chill. Goes for the down 4-2. Knee playing it safe. He's going to duck it into his face.
Yo, it's a legend kick that was tight. Double's playing so unpredictably right now. I love it.
Oh, the chase.
Can't counter me if you don't know when I'm gonna hit.
Right. Stop trying to hit me and hit me.
You can't.
Punish.
No. The fakie.
Dang,
God.
He just hit a rip. That was definitely a rip move.
Yeah, he unzipped and let the balls out. You know, that was too much. Too much.
That was good. Break his legs. Banana peel.
Hey.
Good check. Man, he is pushing Knee to this wall. Nice punish. Thought it was a down two.
Close.
Look at the sidewalking.
Nice. Good block. Important block there. Double still in this.
Down 4-3. Be careful with those lows, Mr. Double. What an answer. Just instantly to the wild rise. Instantly. Didn't even hesitate.
That was close, though. Double was blow for blow with him there until the end. And Knee closing it out. Taking the first game. 1-0 here. This is winner side of the bracket.
Oh, man. Okay. And it just seems like Double was doing, he wasn't doing bad in most of those matches.
No, definitely not. As I mentioned, he was being very unpredictable. One of the things I really like about Double's playstyle, he'll use Law Standing 4 into nothing. You know, like a lot of Law players, myself included, just like to, you know you can DSS off it, right?
Yeah.
So you'll go Law Standing 4 into stance and do a stance option. Double likes to do Law Standing 4 DSS forward 2, and then sometimes he'll go forward 2 back 2, which is the 2-hit strength.
Okay.
So, like, those are his options. So he does either nothing or one of those two things. So he keeps it real compact, real tight. Not a lot of room to hang himself. But I was talking about earlier, he gets so comfortable doing it that he's going to get clipped by a down 4-2 eventually, or back 1, because he just goes and ducks in his face to pull out the wall standing 4.
Okay. I mean, it makes sense what he's doing, right?
Yeah, like that, see?
Yeah.
He just runs up to do a wall standing 4 DSS mix-up sometimes, and wall standing 4 into nothing.
And
there's the back
one.
Yeah. And that's what it is. This is how Knee plays, too, with Steve. It's beautiful. He gets comfortable. He lets you get comfortable attack him. And he's like, look, I'm not going to back one you. I'm not going to down with you. I promise. And then boom, back one.
Okay. So Double having a hard time even getting to the back one. He's having such a hard time of opening Knee up.
It's really hard to open up Steve with Law now because down back three is Law's best low poke, right? But it's standing. So that means you can get countered by the back one. And if you go for any of the other ones, you get countered by the down 4-2. So, with most characters, very hard to just poke Steve down. I like the flip kick attempt on Knee, ready for the punish.
Okay.
And see, now he's going for the down 4-1s, trying to mix things up here, but Knee's defense is just so good.
He's trying to scare Knee, and Knee's not budging at all.
Yeah, Tuto, Neve, ready for the throw break. There's a down back three. And this is what you want to do, because Neve's not really throwing a lot of back ones. And there it is, right? Because he's like, all right, you keep wanting to throw the down back threes. I'm going to see hit you standing this counter. Nice down forward two all the way to the wall. Resplat for the wall combo. Ugh!
Good damage.
Beautiful, beautiful combo.
Look how long it took him to get there, though. Even with half life still on his bar.
He's got, it's going to be a grind against Neve Steve.
Yeah.
You know, you just got to stick with it.
Oh. Look at this offense, man. They are dancing point blank range.
Oh,
oh wow. Okay. That wild standing four DSS cancel the legend.
God.
Wow.
And he blocks the wild standing one, two.
Oh, but you ain't blocking his back one, baby.
Damn.
Put him to sleep standing up.
Oh. Wake him up, Steve.
The wall will do it. Oh. Oh, you gotta be.
Hey.
Oh, rewall splat.
No!
Nah.
Not against me, man.
Yeah. You see,
like,
what he's been doing?
It's one thing to do it when they're back to the wall, because then at least the risk reward is a little bit more in your favor. Like, if it hits, you get a wall splat. But when they're back to the open, like, what are you going to get out of that, really? It's too risky.
Okay. Oh. Okay. Hey. Nice punish. And he is banking on him swinging. He is banking on it. And he has no problem throwing out those back ones while standing two coming
from
double.
He wanted that. He wanted that so bad. He's like, I want this back one. A beautiful wall carry.
Oh, my damn it.
That was the perfect wall carry. Tommy stops the rage drive. No Sonic Drive for you. Final round. Double still in it.
This dude, double. Taking his time. Finding that proper route. Threading the needle in a lot of these instances.
Get
no break on the throw.
What the hell? No break on the throw. 3 plus 4, down 2, 3, beautiful, excellent choice. Hey!
Get up.
Oh, the flip kick off the crowd stash!
Wall standing 4.
He's getting nutty. Just stop hitting buttons, double. Just stop hitting buttons. You've got the lead. It's Steve Fox.
Be careful.
If you hit buttons, it's going to counter
you. We haven't seen a back 2 yet.
Stop hitting buttons!
Oh, the rage drive! What are you doing? It's might have cost
him. It's over!
Oh, no. And you told him. You told him. You told double to back off.
Couldn't hear.